At this time, Madam Chairman, I'd like to recognize the ranking member of the Readiness Subcommittee, Mr. Lamborn of Colorado.
Gentlemen.
For 2 minutes.
2 minutes.
I thank the gentleman for yielding. Madam Speaker, I rise today in support of H.R. 4350. We have maintained the bipartisan tradition of the Armed Services Committee. Now, while this administration promotes weakness abroad and tyranny at home, robust support for the defense in this bill ensures that our adversaries understand that our military has the resources required to stymie their aggressive ambitions, which will guarantee that our military will succeed if called upon. This legislation will enhance readiness by funding the unfunded requests of the services and the COCOMs. It will maintain our commitment to the nuclear triad and modernization and aggressively enhance our space capabilities. It protects our troop against punishment for personal politics, prohibits dishonorable discharge for COVID vaccination refusal, and requires a plan for exemptions. And it begins to hold the Biden administration accountable for Afghanistan. Now, while this bill fosters U.S.-Israeli cooperation, including $300 million for multiple collaborative programs, anti-Israel Democrats have stripped the continuing resolution of $1 billion for the Iron Dome missile defense system. What does it say about the Progressive Caucus that they object to Israeli citizens defending themselves from missile attacks? It is reprehensible and anti-Semitic. Nevertheless, this bill, as it currently stands, is a bipartisan bill. I thank the chairman and ranking member for maintaining the collaborative nature of our committee. I want to thank especially the chairman of the Readiness Subcommittee, John Garamendi, for his leadership and commitment to bipartisanship. And I thank my readiness team, Ian, Dave, and Whitney, for their invaluable hard work during this process. I encourage a yes vote, and I yield back.
Gentlemen from